Welcome to WatchGuard's Daily Security Byte. I'm Corey Nachreiner. On Wednesday, we learned of a spy versus spy hack-off between two APT gangs. Kaspersky, one of WatchGuard's partners, released some interesting research about two big threat actors kind of going after each other. It begins with phishing emails from Nikon, which is a well-known cyber actor in the South China Sea that goes after military and government and diplomat organizations in the Philippines and Malaysia and places like that, and was particularly active after that Malaysian airline disappeared a year ago. Anyways, they sent out a bunch of targeted phishing emails, and one of the organizations they sent it to, who Kaspersky calls HealthSing, actually recognized the phishing email as an attack, and they replied back. Rather than opening this malicious document in the email, they actually tried to pretend to verify that the sender was really who they said they were. And during that time period, they also got more clues showing that Nikon really was a threat actor. So in response to this, HealthSing sent their own return email containing a password protected archive file, which in itself had its own Trojan. So this is a case of one attacker attacking another attacker. And Kaspersky calls this an APT versus APT gang and describe it as a first of its kind. Now personally, I don't necessarily know if these are really APT gangs. And this is not the first of its kind. If you followed botnets for years, bot herders and criminal actors, whether they be big criminal actors or just script kiddies, have often gotten these sorts of cyber fights. For instance, a lot of bot herders often try to take over the command and control center of other bot herders in order to get their victims. Now, Kaspersky seems to be implying that these are advanced actors and perhaps nation states, although they don't really attribute this to anyone. Anyways, who cares if this is APT actors or just normal criminals? What you probably care about is what we can learn from this. And really, this was phishing 101. This was not an advanced threat, in my opinion. So really, normal email handling practices apply. Don't interact with unsolicited attachments, even if they're just documents, because documents can be malicious. Be very careful with links and emails. Don't open password-protected archives. That's often a sign. And in the worst case, if you think something is legitimate, you might still want to verify it with the sender, because that communication might tip you off that something funny is going on. Finally, keep your system patched and up to date, because often these have to take advantage of vulnerabilities in your system in order to work. So if you just use email common sense, this sort of attack shouldn't affect you. And personally, I don't believe in attacking your attacker. Defense is your best option. That's it for today. Thank you for watching.